Hey everybody, today we're going to learn how to add additional content to your Storyline xAPI triggers. So if you don't want it to show up in the basic statements of the actor, the verb, and the object, but you want to provide additional content in the description, I'm going to show you how to do that and how to adjust the trigger inside of Storyline to be able to do that. So let's go ahead and get started. Welcome back. If you haven't checked out my website already, go ahead and check out my website at learningdojo.ninja. Here you can check out all previous blog posts, everything to do with learning developments on Articulate Storyline 360, Adobe Captivate, also augmented reality, and just learning production in general. You can also download different templates from Articulate Storyline 360, and these are all free templates as well. You can also download some xAPI templates, the PDF xAPI tracker, as well as YouTube and Vimeo trackers as well. And then even strategy templates you can download from my website. And if you're new to any of these different tools, you can also check out full courses, everything from A to Z, on Articulate Storyline 360, Adobe Captivate, xAPI Fundamentals, Articulate Rise, Custom SCORM, and HTML5 Video. In my previous videos that you can check out here, I cover everything that you need to know to get started with xAPI, the xAPI triggers inside of Articulate Storyline, which are great by default, especially if you're publishing to CMI5 or an xAPI package and you're uploading it to your learning management system. However, I'm going to show you kind of a limitation that is out of the box and how we can extend it here. So I have just a basic page, just trying to make this as simple as possible here. And inside of Storyline, all I'm going to do is add on an xAPI trigger. So once I click on the add trigger here, I'm going to select the drop-down box to be an xAPI trigger here. So send xAPI statement. And then I'm going to select one of the different verbs that are available. And this could be answered, asked. I mean, you could do other ones. I have other videos on how to change out the verb as well. But let's say that we just want to do satisfied for now. And then we can describe the object. Now the object could be like what button they've clicked on, or it could be like what page they visited, or any variable information that you have. But let's just go into custom text for now. So we're going to say button one. So they satisfied, let's say acknowledgements. So they satisfied the acknowledgements or something like that. So I'm going to hit enter there. When it comes into our learning record store, or when it comes into our learning management system, if it's xAPI enabled, it will basically say Jeff Bat satisfied acknowledgments. I could probably add the acknowledgement or something like that. But if you wanted to expand upon this, like what acknowledgements, did they accomplish something else? You want to use another variable in the course to be included in this as well. That's where the description comes into play. Because if you start to add on that initial phrase, add on to that initial phrase of Jeff Bat satisfied acknowledgments on ethics 101 in blah, 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 that statement gets pretty long. And so it starts to initially look a lot longer than you probably want it to have. So you want to keep those statements as short as possible so we can add to the description here. However, there's a problem inside of Storyline. If we click on this plus xAPI, the problem is it only gives us, and this is JSON data. xAPI data is essentially JSON data. So that's just how it has like a key and a value pair of like what it is and then what the information is. That's how we provide it here. But it really only gives us the name. Well, we can do more than this. We can actually have a description as well. But how do I type this in? If you're not familiar with JSON, it's very picky. So if I delete like a comma or have an extra comma or something like that, there's going to be an error. Well, the way that I do this is by using a tool, and I'll provide the link down in the description below. This is from the ADL, which is the government organization that is over xAPI. But this is a statement generator. Now this statement generator gives us that JSON data. So it's exactly what we need. But in order to get that, I need to fill out some kind of default information here. And I don't really need to fill out the name. It's going to generate something automatically for me. It really doesn't matter which one that I pick here because we're going to change that anyways. And what I'm looking for is this description right here. So let's compare this to what we have. We have the name, so we want to have that acknowledgement, which I misspelled acknowledgement. I'm sorry, I'm live typing here. This is never a good thing for me. But you can see here that it doesn't have the description. Now I looked and I couldn't find anywhere for me to add on the description under xAPI, under the objects here. What happens if I select object? It basically just selects the object content, but it did not have the ability to add on that description unless I type it out myself. Well, I don't want to type it out myself. So really what I want to do is I want to grab this comma right here and I want to copy from that comma down here. The comma is important because anytime you have more than one thing that's kind of on the same line here, it needs to have a comma between the next one, but not on the last one. Again, JSON is very picky that way, but if I just go ahead and paste that there, you'll notice now I have that comma there, and I can kind of delete some spaces to make this even as well. It's nicer if it does it for you automatically, but you can see that in this case, it did not. So I'm just gonna hit tab on that one, and then I'm gonna delete the spaces there so it looks a little bit better. Well, within these quotes, we can change this to whatever we want. You need to keep the quotes, but we just basically come in here and say, well, what acknowledgement? Acknowledgement on ethics 101 in blah, 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 and so forth. And then we can also add on if we have variable information, elapsed time. They did this in the amount of time in the entire slide or in the entire project. So project elapsed time. This would also provide the elapsed time there. So in, I would say in that. So you can add on to this. You can have this that's optional data, and I'll show you how that's done. So if I click OK, and then I click OK here, I can always go back into that statement. If I click on, once this shows up, all I have to do is click on Custom xAPI Statement 1, and it takes me back to that editor. But let's go ahead and publish this out and see what it looks like inside of a learning record store. So I'm going to go ahead and publish to CMI5. And we are going to just hit publish from there. Now I'm going to use SCORM Cloud, so I can go to a free account, so cloud.scorm.com, and you can sign up for a free account right down here. And this I use for a lot of testing for xAPI data as it comes in. And I have a lot of different videos on how to do that, set this up and everything. I'm gonna go into this xAPI data. Actually, let's go into our library first, and we're going to add our content, our CMI5 package here. So I'm gonna click on browse, and it hasn't finished yet, or did finish, but we need to zip it up. So I'm gonna zip this up here. And once it's zipped, I can now come back into here and I can upload it. Oh, it zipped in my Articulate project. Let me zip it again, and let me actually zip it on my desktop here. And there we go. So there's my zip file. Let's go ahead and upload it. Click on import course. All right, now we can go ahead and launch it here. Click on launch course, and all we have is one button. So all I need to do is go ahead and click on xAPI statement. I did not add like an alert or something like a message. I probably would want to do that. Usually when you click on a button and nothing happens, that looks like an error to the user. So I always tell my students to make sure that you have something pop up. But in this case, we're just testing out the data. So I'm gonna go ahead and close that course inside of SCORM Cloud. And you can see the data for this course. If it's a CMI5 package, you can see that data inside of View Registration Statement History. Now, let's go to the satisfied one. So Jeff Batt satisfied, I believe that's the one that I actually chose. Go back into my statements here. Yeah, I did satisfied. And then project, I think it switched it over to the project title, which is, it's fine. So I think the title would probably be this one right here. Yep, there it is. So it gives me this information. So initially we keep it clean. I probably want to switch this over because when I change it over to a custom one, it like changed it back to the project title, which you can easily do by coming into these quotes and then just changing this to acknowledgement again. So now it would say acknowledgement instead of untitled slide. But if I expand that out, this is the key part right here. It has now given me the description with that additional information that's not shown by default. And then it's showing this in my project elapsed time. 5381, what does that mean? That's actually in milliseconds. And so it's actually 5,000 in milliseconds is 5 seconds. So we didn't spend that long. And so 5 seconds, 5.3 seconds we spent on this. And then we, when the xAPI statement got sent over. So hopefully that shows you that you can add on to this statement, this custom statement, and add on the description and give it more context, give it more explanation, basically, without having to add it all onto the title here. And so I just wanted to show you that. You can use this statement generator to be able to do that. Hopefully Storyline has that there by default. They did when they initially launched it. I'm not sure why they got rid of it, but hopefully they add it back and allows us to customize or add on to that. You could, if you wanted to type it out yourself, you could type it out yourself. I just use a statement generator to make sure that I got everything correctly there. So hopefully that helps you. If you like this video, go to my YouTube channel, click on that like button, and subscribe to my channel as well, and click that notification button so you get notified of all future videos as they come out. That really helps my channel so I can continue to provide these videos for you and continue to help you in your learning development as well. And also, if you wanted to check out more content, you can check out my website, learningdojo.ninja. You can check out my blog, all the different templates that are available, and especially my courses, everything from A to Z and how to use Articulate Storyline 360, Adobe Captivate, xAPI Fundamentals from Scratch, Articulate Rise, Custom SCORM, and HTML5 Video. That's all I have for this week. So thanks, everyone, and I'll see you next time.